Day two of training camp 2.0 here at the Scotiabank Saddledome. The Calgary Flames about back at work and pleased to be joined by David Riddick. And we got a little bit of a different setup for you and for me here, but it's good to see you nonetheless. How are you doing?
Yeah, I'm good. Finally back. Excited to be back with the boys and get the hockey feelings back and be ready to go to the Hub City and play some playoff games.
I know you've been back skating in smaller groups before this, but what is it like now two sessions into, you know, more of a regular skating and kind of being back with a bigger group?
Obviously, it's every time when I'm coming here, like before the camp, it's always easier. And during like the first three days during the camp, it's a little more intense and the guys really pump it up. So it's good to be back, and yeah, it's always harder like the first 2 days in the camp.
How much did you miss, you know, just this, just kind of a feeling of normalcy, just a feeling of you know, routine?
I mean, to get normal, it's still far away, but it's good. How I said before, it's good to be around the boys and get the jokes and stuff like that. And on the ice, you know, it's always better when you can skate, when you can practice with your team and the guys what you love.
Maybe just take me through for you, where in terms of the break, I mean, how much of a benefit was it for you? Obviously circumstances which are difficult to be sure, but you know, how much did you take advantage of at least the downtime to get some rest and come back healthy?
Yeah, for sure. It was you know, it was kind of really bad in one side, but another side was good for me. I had some problems what I figured out, and I could work on our house back home. So I did a lot of stuff during this break.
Your new house? Would we renovate some homework, or what did you have going on at home?
Yeah, it was a lot of things what was going on. We just built it last year, and we just spent like couple of weeks there. So we were still working on it to sort it out how we want to have it.
Good stuff. All right, well, let's talk about the actual on ice. How much are you looking forward to an opportunity to have that playoff feel? I know it's a qualifying round, but as we know, a best of five and an opportunity to play in the Stanley Cup playoffs. You know, to embrace that opportunity that you have ahead of you.
It's perfect. I'm really excited. That's the best time in hockey, playoff hockey and playoff games. So that's why we work hard during whole season, and it's just up to us how we gonna play, and it's up to us how we gonna figure out to be ready.
You've been through many camps at different levels. Maybe this one's a little bit different, but just in terms of yourself personally, what are you hoping to take away here from the next 2 weeks or to make sure that you're in the right spot?
Obviously the hockey feelings and hockey sense, because everything what I did back home was great. Like my summer camp, like working out and going on the ice was really good. So I'm feeling really good on this side, but the hockey sense and hockey feelings are a little different. So that's what I'm hoping I'm going to get back, and I know I'm going to get back, so I'm going to be ready for the qualification round or whatever you want to call that.
Yeah, whatever it is, the play-in. Do you find that comes back fast usually in terms of time away and then when you do finally get that routine back?
Yeah, it's usually pretty fast. You know, it's just a couple of days to get the feelings, because, you know, when you're working out and practicing in the summer, it's about the condition. It's about the extra shift. What do you have to do, and to be hard on yourself. And when you come in on the cap, you have to work hard. But on the other side, you kind of want to get feelings back and want to be ready for the games.
All right. Well, listen, we appreciate the time, and I know looking forward to the next couple of weeks here of on ice action, and eventually getting back to game time, which I'm sure you're looking forward to as well.
Yeah. Thanks, Brendan.